our level 101 improv work in progress show. So what you're going to be seeing tonight, our students have been working very hard the last 7 weeks, and we're just going to be showing you a little bit of some of the skills we've been working on. So everybody's been working really hard, and I'm really proud of them, and I hope that you're going to have a really fun night too. Woo! So by round of applause, who is this their first time here at Arcade Comedy? Welcome. We are Pittsburgh's only nonprofit comedy theater right here in beautiful downtown Pittsburgh. And we're super glad to have you. If this looks fun to you, talk to me later about joining a comedy class next time. We've got sketch, we've got stand-up, we have improv, which you're going to see right now. So without further ado, let's go ahead and start with our first game. Our first game requires all of our players to hop up on stage. This game is called Peeve Rants, and it's all about things that make you upset. So what I want you to start to do is think of things that make you angry, like taxes or the high cost of milk. Just start shouting them out to me. What?
Traffic.
Somebody else. Religion. All religions. Religion. Capital R.
Acne.
What? Politics. Yeah. We need one more.
Yeah,
work.
Just work. Work makes us mad. These are fantastic suggestions, everyone. Thank you so much. To review, we have
traffic,
religion,
acne,
politics, work.
Fantastic. We now present to you pet peeve rants. There's one up.
So much. It pisses me off, and I know it makes my mom angry, but I don't care. It makes me so mad. Who are you to shove your religion down my throat? I don't care, man. Get off my back. I just want to party. I mean, like, I gotta go to church every day? Communion? What was that about? I didn't want the wafer. I was on a diet.
Politics. I can't stand politics. I hate Congress. I hate the Senate. I hate the State Senate. I really hate the General Assembly. And that fucking governor with that ball, that head, and the glasses. He looks like a cricket. Get the fuck out of here, Governor.
You know what I hate more than anything is traffic. I am so much more important than everyone out there, and they expect me to just wait like everyone else. Do you know who I am? I should not be sitting in traffic. I should have a chauffeur. But instead, I gotta be 30 minutes late to my job because this asshole doesn't know how to get into the left turn lane. I hate it so much. I don't
work. And work. Every morning, let's go to work. Let's go, and we're gonna enrich ourselves. Find a career that you love and get really into. That's all bullshit. There's no such thing. You go, and you hope that they pay you, and then they don't pay you very much.
I hate acne. Every time I have a big event, I'm so excited, and the cutest guy's across the room, and I wake up with a giant pimple on my forehead. And then I have to walk around like this all day. And then they try to sell you all these products. There's like 10 million products, and they never work. They never work. I always get acne, and I hate it. It's the worst.
What are we supposed to do? Just sit around and wait with everyone? I mean, gosh, who do they
think
I am?
Really?
I got my driver's license.
Try doing that all the time.
Enough so that I'll sit around and wait with everyone else.
What are you going to do? You have no choice in the matter at all. You have to do it every day. Go to work.
And then they've got the
religion is terrible. And don't get me started on six, but more than that, religion.
They can't agree
religion
on anything.
Sucks.
The country is going to pot. What do they do? They just raise money and fight, put on commercials, and hate the commercials.
Too, but definitely not a god.
So boring. Why do they have to oppress us with the goddamn commercials?
And then they've got those commercials with the Neutrogena girls, and they always look so perfect. They don't have acne. They don't know what it's like. They can pay them
$1 million. Oh, God, it's so terrible.
Oh, God, you're not going to do that. No, I'm not going to do that.
And
that's why I hate acne.
And work, you have to go
and
work.
Those commercials.
25-year-old.
What gets around a week before the election?
That's all you see on television. You know what he's talking about. anything at all,
and they don't deserve our vote.
They deserve our vote.
Hard as Confederates. A hundred times.
And that's why I hate traffic.
Word at a time story. And so we've got our two players who are going to come down here and they are going to be telling a story. And we've got our other players. We're going to be joined by some of our Monday night class. Everybody, round of applause for our Monday night class. Yeah. So what's going to be happening is our two players over here are going to be telling a story, but they're not going to be telling us a story in the usual way. They're going to be telling us a story one word at a time. So all they need, and while they're telling our story, our actors are going to be portraying the story for your viewing pleasure. So all these guys need is a title of a story that's never been written, like The Antelope's Christmas or The Train That Went Round and Round Forever. It'll be anything.
The baby who went on vacation.
The baby who went on vacation? That's fantastic. Okay, guys, come on down here. We now present the baby who went on vacation.
Once
upon
a
time,
there
was
a
baby
who
went
on
vacation.
He
burned
very
much.
It was
awful.
So much
that
he
cried.
What
did
his
parents
do?
They
went
off
on
a
tangent.
The
baby
cried
more.
And
the
baby
was
dying.
The
baby
laid
too
long
to
be
fed
by
his
parents.
So
they
dropped
him
on
the
ground
because
they
thought
he
might
poop.
They
then
picked
up
the
baby
and
threw
him
into
the
ocean.
Never
again
to
see
or
hear
his
crying.
The end.
Called Arms Expert. This is going to be played with four players. While they're setting up chairs, we need some suggestions from you, our audience. The first thing that we need is a small animal, something that could fit inside a bread box.
Chinchilla.
What? A hamster is the first thing I heard. And then the next thing that we need is a sport or an activity.
Tennis.
So it is hamsters and tennis. All right, we now take you to this talk show already in progress.
Hello, folks, and welcome back to our show, Fun with Hamsters. We have got a very special guest for us today. His name is Bob Hampton, and he is going to tell us about his hamsters. Bobby, what makes your hamsters so special?
They're extremely intelligent. Art over there, he's got an IQ of 165. He's much smarter than me.
Wow, so how do you test a hamster's IQ?
By the way, they play tennis, of course. What do you think?
Well, you know, I don't have experience with this. This is our first time with tennis playing gangsters on this show. Can you tell me a little bit about the training process?
Well, they get up every morning at 5 o'clock. They eat, you know, I feed them. I give them meatloaf. That's their favorite food. Meatloaf, yes.
Yeah. So you know, I understand. So you said you have Art over there. What are the other, actually four others, what are their names?
Griselda, Maud, and Harry.
What's that really fat one?
Oh, that's Harry.
So I understand that they're going to show us, do a little demonstration for us.
Yes, they are. They're going to play a little round of tennis here.
Great.
You see the net?
Yes. Did you make that yourself?
No, they made it.
Their own, or do you train them to make their nets?
No, they train themselves. All I do is sit there and watch.
And I see one keeping score. Wow. IQ really comes in handy.
I hope they're not cheating. They do that sometimes.
Now, it looks like they're getting into a fight. What should we do?
Just let them fight. Okay. You know, it's what they do for recreation.
Special call, the way that you would get them over here, because I would love to pick one of these up. They're so cute.
Oh!
Oh! Oh! I got three of them in my lap, and oh, I'm gonna put two of them up in my hands. I need to shuffle them.
That's fine. Yes, they enjoy that. It stimulates them.
One of them is quite tall from my lap to here.
That's Griselda.
This is the largest hamster I have ever seen in my life.
And she's also the smartest hamster you've ever seen.
I see. So tell me a little bit more about this one. So we've got Griselda, and who's this?
That's Maud.
Okay.
Maud sings.
Oh, wow. Could Maud sing now? Is that possible?
Yeah, I have to get her started.
Okay. Sounds like a special treat.
Okay. See, doe, a deer, a female deer, ray, a drop of gold.
I think okay. This is helping. I think this, if I rub them like this.
Oh, no, that's not the right thing to do. That'll get the...
Ow! It bit me. Griselda bit me.
Griselda! How dare you? You don't do that to... Nice talk show host.
I think that's all the time we have for today. Thank you, Bobby. Everyone, let's help me. Well, thank Bobby. Thank you so much for coming on our show and for bringing your hamsters. And is there a medic?
See. From our other class up on stage. This game is called String of Pearls. And it's required everybody. There's some chairs here. Excellent. So for this game, we're gonna tell you guys another story, but we're not going to tell it to you in the typical way that you would imagine in order. All we need to get started is a different title of the story. Something like the awesome baby vacation one. Who knew where that was going to take us? What?
No.
Oh, that's right. How about from over here?
The goose that couldn't fly.
Oh, that's so good. I love it. The goose that couldn't fly. Ladies and gentlemen, for the first and possibly last time ever, the goose who couldn't fly.
There once was a mighty goose.
And in the end, he just plopped down.
There once was a mighty goose.
Even though he only had one wing.
In the end, he just plopped down.
There once was a mighty goose.
And so he went to the king of the goose.
Even though he only had one wing.
In the end, he plopped down.
There once was a mighty goose.
And so he went to the king of the geese.
He only had one wing.
He did the best he could.
In the end, he plopped down.
There once was a mighty goose.
And he went to the king of the geese.
And he asked for one wish.
Even though he only had one wing.
He did the best he could. In the end, he just plopped down.
There once was a mighty goose.
He traveled many miles to a kingdom.
And he went to the king of the geese.
And he asked for one wish.
Even though he only had one wing.
He did the best he could. In the end, he just plopped down.
There once was a mighty goose.
He traveled many miles to the kingdom.
And he went to the king of the geese.
And he asked for one wish.
Even though he only had one wing.
He did the best he could.
He flew and he flew, but in the end, he fell to the ground.
And in the end, he just plopped down.
And there once was a mighty goose.
He traveled many miles to the kingdom.
And he went to the king of the geese.
And he asked for one wish.
Even though he only had one wing.
He did the best he could.
And then the wind was too strong.
He flew and he flew, but in the end, he just fell down.
And in the end, he just plopped down.
This requires three players. We're gonna grab a couple of chairs. So we're gonna be doing, we're gonna be improvising a scene for you here with our three players up here, but there's a catch. At any point in the scene, one of our players has to be sitting, one of our players has to be standing, and one of our players has to be leaning, okay? And we're gonna need your help. If you see two players who are both doing the same thing, two players sitting or two players standing or three players, you're gonna give them, you're gonna let them know by going, ooh. Everybody try that, ready? Ooh, yes, bonus points for the people who use their hands. Very nice. All we need to get started is a suggestion of a location, something that would fit on this stage. Like a cafe.
Laundry room.
A laundry room, lovely. We now take you to this laundry room.
God, I know when we signed up to work in the laundry room, I didn't think that all we'd be doing is folding all day long.
I can't believe all we do is fold. My arms are so tired.
My arms are tired too. I really need to stretch them.
My
stretch
back them out. You know?
And I can't decide whether to sit or stand.
That's the best way. I can't figure out how do you fold laundry the best way. How do you fold?
It really is confusing.
I can't wait to get home to my
and
kids.
This washer.
Forget about it.
Never-ending. I mean, does this thing even work? I swear, half the things that I take out aren't even clean. I have to wash them again.
This is a sweatshop.
That's what it is. I can't believe I've been working here for so many years, and it took you to tell me to realize I work in a sweatshop.
I don't even think that this thing's like what I mean.
I don't think it is either.
What are we gonna do?
Oh, there's probably hamsters in here somewhere running. It doesn't even work.
Here, let me take a look.
Okay.
But watch this, they bite.
Are there hamsters in that place?
It bit you?
It was just a false alarm. I think it was just a dust.
Working at this sweatshop is hard. Harder than I thought.
But if we don't get back to folding this laundry, you know what's going to happen.
What, we're not going to get a crappy paycheck?
That's right.
Oh my gosh, the boss is coming.
Oh! Hey man, what's going on? Now we're just folding clothes, nothing to see here, but I think there's a hamster in this. Okay, bye. Oh, he's gone, thank God.
That
took a lot out of me. Folding these clothes.
But don't leave the towels on the ground because the hamsters will get in.
I thought there's...
Is that what those holes are from?
That's probably it.
Whatever, I don't care anyways. I'm done with this
job. I just realized this. I want to apply to another job. I've been thinking about this for a while.
Subway's hiring.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I'd much rather make sandwiches.
Food service.
Yeah. Yes. Than folding laundry.
Right.
Yeah, I could be folding bread.
My back hurts so bad.
My hands are getting gnarled just from.
Yeah, I have arthritis.
That's right.
And all these hamster bites. My medical bills are through the roof.
You can't even afford a tetanus shot.
Translator requires four players, and we gotta grab a couple more chairs. There we go. Fantastic. So, what we need, fantastic. So, we've got a situation in that our two players on either end of the seats. They don't happen to speak the same language, but luckily we have our trusty translators here in the middle, and they're going to be translating so these two ladies can have a conversation. So all we need to get started is a suggestion of a relationship. It could be a personal relationship, like mother-daughter, professional, like doctor-patient.
Lovers.
Wow, she really drew that out. Lovers. Excellent. You are lovers.
Why do you always go to the garbage?
I like the way it smells.
You like the way it smells. What about all that old food?
It's very healthy, natural. It helps out the environment.
Maybe I could try it.
Watch a tuka leg and you go.
Oh, yum.
I would love you forever if you tried it.
Body da da wada boo diddy bada.
I love you very much, but maybe not as much as stinky garbage.
Onishita luka chiga fan wu wah wah wah. You've just hurt me so much by saying you don't love me as much as garbage.
I used to love you a lot more, but then you would act crazy and you would make these weird noises like.
Anishta Gulaha, Gulaha, Niburaru. You make weird sounds in the shower, and I hate the way you're always singing as you're trying to get dressed.
Maybe we can make weird noises together.
See. Got another game for you. Thank you for the people who filled out some of our suggestions out in the lobby. We're gonna use them now with this next game. It's called Blind Line. The way this works is our two players are gonna grab a couple of lines. They have not read these. They have been in our possession. Three lines. And what's going to happen is they're going to be performing a scene, and then at various points of the scene, they're going to pull out one of your lines, read them, and then they're going to have to justify in the scene why exactly they've said this line that was written, not one that they came up with, one that you wrote for them. So all our players need is, how about a different location than laundry room from before, something different.
Zoo.
Hawaii.
A zoo in Hawaii. We now take you to the zoo in Hawaii.
Oh, honey, it's so romantic. Look at that panda bear.
To be able to see a panda in this paradise, this makes everything we work for all the better. Although, gotta watch, because I've heard they've got some snakes and hamsters.
Hamsters in Hawaii. Remember when we said our vows yesterday and I told you that maybe she's born with it, maybe it's me thing? Because we fell in love over that commercial. Remember? It was like our first kiss.
I saw the eyes of the woman in that ad. And then I glanced into your eyes and I thought, it's more than Maybelline. So yeah, it did bring back great memories.
Yeah, that was a magical moment.
It was a magical moment. It had me thinking quite a bit. The whole thing was good to the last drop.
Yeah, that's what you said over coffee this morning.
It really just fit right in to the whole thing. Maybelline, coffee, pandas, hamsters, the whole thing.
So I think what we should spend the rest of our lives doing is, ice cream is a vegetable. because it's delicious, but it's also healthy because it's got lactose, like milk, and coffee.
And I believe I read somewhere that here in Hawaii, they do make ice cream out of vegetables.
Really?
Yes, turnip, squash, all those sorts of things.
Interesting.
Oh, yeah. That's how they get those little colors.
Do you think we can buy some here at the zoo?
Oh, I'm sure they have it, yeah. I mean, they've got everything else.
Sounds good.
Yeah, definitely. So we should go look and check that out. I'll put my reminder in the free section of Craigslist.
Don't you remember what happened last time?
I thought we could find some ice cream, but we didn't go that way. Yeah. Still work out.
Yeah, and I think we told that guy, frankly, my dear, I don't give a damn. He showed up and he said he wanted to murder us. So,
So that was good, because it could have turned out really badly. So, and, you know, after he left, I even felt myself having to say, why would you say that? But looking back, it fits. It got him out of the house. You know, I thought Craigslist, he was just there for sex.
See? Special guest that I'd like to introduce to you tonight, all the way from his TED Talk in Palo Alto, we have Dr. Know-It-All. Dr. Know-It-All is the smartest known being in the universe and can answer questions on any topic. It could be science, it could be pop culture, it could be arts and literature. And I'm going to be coming to you, the audience, for some questions here in just a minute. So start thinking about what kinds of questions you'd like to ask Dr. Know-It-All. But actually, before we begin, I have a question for Dr. Know-It-All. Dr. Know-It-All, you know, Farmer's Almanac says that it's going to be a really, really cold winter. I'm curious, what do you think?
Well,
that
is
a lie.
More
questions.
All right. Farmer's Almanac lies all these years. Woo. All right, now we know. So if you have a question for Dr. Know-It-All, just raise your hand. And yes, you, sir.
Why is Pluto not a planet anymore?
Ah, we have a Neil deGrasse Tyson fan in the audience. Why exactly is Pluto no longer a planet?
Pluto
is
not
a planet
because
it's too
small
and it
is too
chunky.
It is
hard
to
live
on
a Pluto.
More questions.
Dr. Know-It-All is not a fan of Pluto, for sure. Yes. Oh, dear Lord. Dr. Know-It-All, this Republican wants to know, how exactly is Donald Trump going to be as our president?
Everyone
thinks
he will
brush
his
hair
and
not care
because
he is
really
attractive. However,
Trump
is
not
smart
at anything.
He
will
die.
More questions.
Wow, it sounds like it's going to be a tragic tale. So we have time for a couple more questions.
Apply makeup so I look like a Disney character.
Oh, all right. This woman in the audience wants to know, how could she maybe apply makeup so she could look more like a Disney character?
Cinderella
was
a beautiful
princess
and lived
happily
in her
lair
where her
hair
was
perfect.
Just
like her
fingers.
Because
makeup.
More questions.
Did you get that? Awesome. Fantastic. We have, how about somebody over here on this side of the room? A question for Dr. Know-It-All on any topic. Oh, yes, from the booth. Yes, sir.
If I want to retire at 50, how much money will I need if I'm going to live until like 65?
All right. This guy wants to retire early. How much money would he need in order to live to 65?
$1.
A
minute
will
take everything
to
the
next
level.
More questions.
That is pretty financially conservative. $1 a minute. Just put that away for yourself. Great. We have time for one more question. Sadly, Dr. Know-It-All has to be whisked away to MIT later. Do we have one more question for Dr. Know-It-All? Yes, ma'am.
Why did the Pope really come to the USA?
Cool. This woman in the audience thinks that maybe the Pope had a secret agenda. Could you tell us, why did he actually come to America?
Trump
asked
him to
come
and
the
girl
was
ready.
Also,
the
Trump
was
meager
to get
with
Pope.
No more questions.
Talking about a little bit in here is character and the idea of developing characters on stage. And so this is actually a fun game slash exercise that we played that we're going to show you. This game is called Hitchhiker, and we have our two players. They are off on a road trip to somewhere like Vegas. Where are they off to?
Vegas.
Iowa.
Iowa is the first thing I heard. So these guys are on the road to Iowa, and along the way, we're going to meet some interesting hitchhikers. So we take you to this road trip already in progress.
Boy, it's boring getting to Iowa. Hey, there's a hitchhiker. Let's pull over and let her in. If she ever gets it.
Wow.
Yeah.
I'm gonna miss the caucus.
I'll quit your moaning.
Oh, Beverly, you nasty old coot.
Oh. Oh, you're so grumpy all the time.
Well, I'm going 35 miles an hour.
Oh, you better slow down. It says 25.
Oh, stop your bitching.
Beverly, it says 25. Don't make me hit you with this thing.
I don't know where she's going.
Well, you better take the wheel.
I don't think we have time to wait. We're only going 25.
I have a heart attack if no one takes the wheel.
I think this... I can't tell if that's a cactus or...
I have my reading glasses on.
Come over here, cactus.
Hey. How are you doing?
Hey. See the game last night?
Yeah, I saw it. Also, is this a jitney or so I'm trying to get to Giant Eagle.
I don't know, but get your terrible towel in my face.
Don't talk shit on my towel. Iron coat.
A great one. A great one.
He's a hell of a man. Great announcer.
Actually, I forgot my Yingling. I'm gonna just pull over here. So
that was quick.
All right.
I'll take.
Enjoy your Yingling. Yeah, did you see the game last night?
Yeah, you know, they threw the ball real far. Them Stillers.
Stillers, let's go Bucks. Hey, there's a person. Come on.
Oh my god, hey guys, thank you so much for picking me up.
No problem.
Do you guys want to do some shots in here or something? Do you want some?
Can we have some?
Okay, oh my god. Here you go. Here, take your driving.
For the driver.
Spring break. Woo!
I should probably.
Oh my god, Cheryl. Yeah.
Cheryl!
Cheryl!
Alright.
I'll take over. Let's just leave. She is a hot mess.
She's a slut. Let's go. So
her.
I was
so cool. Out here.
Let's get her!
Woo!
What's your deal? Thanks for pulling me over. I've had a really bad day and I couldn't find a ride. Where are you guys going?
We're going to Iowa.
And then we're going to Iowa. What? Going to Iowa?
We're going nowhere. That's
the worst place in the world. I don't know why we're going.
Why did you just not work?
What was wrong with your day?
Everything. I'm just so emotional.
I'm gonna go cry over here.
Okay. I'll take the wheel. I hate driving.
Hello, ladies. My name is Yuri. I'm from Moscow.
Welcome to our vehicle.
My name is Natasha.
Oh, Natasha. Natasha, when we get to Iowa, how about you and I going to a... Go?
Well, I'm not comfortable with this.
This is a go-go trip. That this is
I think you'd be so good throwing them cow chips, how do you call it?
You know what, I have to go.
I need more
fat.
How about you, young lady?
Hey, don't talk to me. I've got to drive this thing. Oh, look, there's a hitchhiker.
Oh, a hitchhiker.
Yes.
Come on in.
Yes,
my bad. Well, boy, howdy. How you folks been?
Hi.
Oh, so good to see you.
You're heading to Iowa.
We sure are.
Best place on the planet, Iowa.
Come see that Mr. Trump.
Bless your pea-picking heart.
He's a genius.
Yeah.
And he has beautiful hair.
He does. It's sort of swift back there.
Yeah. Yes. Never a hair out of place.
Yeah. So he's driving in a convertible all the time. Yeah.
Oh, I want to pull over right here. They've got a NASCAR poster in the window.
Six pack, that's a good idea. Yeah, hey, look, there's a hitchhiker.
Oh, come on aboard.
I'm not here yet. I want to watch Pokemon. Where's my candy?
Lucy, you know, Iowa's far away. It's going to take us some time to get there. Now let's sit back and read your comic book.
Stop hitting me. Stop hitting me. Stop hitting me.
I know you are.
See. We've got only one more game for you tonight, but haven't these guys been doing a great job?
It's an improv staple. It's called Freeze Tag. The way that this works is two players are going to come out and they're going to be improvising a scene. At some point, someone from the back line is going to say, freeze! These two players are going to freeze in position. Somebody's going to come, tap one of them on the shoulder, adapt their exact physical position, and then start a brand new scene. Two new characters, new location, new topic, new everything. And that's how freeze tag works. So all we need for these two players is, how about a line of dialogue? Maybe something you said to someone else today.
Get a job.
Get a job.
Get a job.
Get a job, you lazy bum.
Listen, I had a job. Connie, man.
I've been working all day long and then I come home to find you on the couch like this.
Yeah, well, can you give me a beer?
Get you a beer? Who do you think I am? Your servant?
I'm tired.
Oh, God, I'm sick of this. I work so hard every day just to see. What do you do? Just do something. Take out the trash. Do something.
I'm tired.
This is long. I just want to pull my hair out.
Does this look good?
Yes, it looks amazing. Yes.
Oh, just like, this white snake is going to be amazing.
I'm going
to come back and don't even know it.
Yes. Oh, I love it. Yes.
Oh, Tawny Katane, eat your heart out.
Yes.
Hi, can we break for lunch?
Yeah, sure.
Freeze. You left crumbs in the bed again.
So what? Who cares? It's not a big deal.
I care.
Do you know how much dead skin is in the bed? It's not a big deal.
I don't mind the dead skin. I mind
you
the
don't
crumbs.
Mind the dead skin. Okay.
No, I don't mind the dead skin.
Listen, man. I'm trying to find the rest of the sandwich that I dropped under the bed, okay? The crumbs are the least of my worries. I made it, and it was so good.
You
I was
dropped
looking...
a sandwich under the bed?
Yeah! I was playing Wii in bed.
Freeze! Why did I let you talk me into going to that place for dinner? You liked it. You had a great time, Drew.
Eat the sushi. It's really good.
You picked the restaurant, Charlie. You told me you love sushi.
I was an idiot.
Freeze.
So child's pose is like this. It's like the yoga, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
You want to do some
yoga?
Try it.
Okay. Yeah. Here, I'll show you. Yeah. So just get on your butt and just stretch out your arms. Or okay, we could do that too. this is great. Or tell me, why did you get into yoga?
I want to relax.
Yeah. What would help is if we did here. Maybe try saying. Try taking taking a deep breath in like this. And then let it out.
Breathe. All right, last window we gotta wash today. My arm keeps flying around.
I heard if you do it like this, it's really good for your arm. It's like really tiny.
Yeah.
I got it from Karate Kid.
Wax on.
Mm-hmm. Wax off, wax that's on. Right. And then you just kind of move down as you go.
Yeah. I think I'm getting changed in there.
I think you might. Oh, he saw us.
Freeze. Hey, we gotta make a big pizza pie today!
Yes,
we got a lot of orders today, Tony.
Yes,
are you ready?
Yes. Pizza pie. Oh, that's a good one.
Oh, hey.
Get this pizza out of the oven.
Make sure you put extra pepperoni,
extra pepperoni.
On it. This one's coming out.
You ready for the club tonight, girl? Ready
yeah.
to go?
Yeah.
Ready to go?
Ready to
I'm
go.
I'm a little nervous, but I'm ready. I'm ready.
We can do shots. Let's do shots.
Okay.
Here we go. All right. You're still a good night.
Woo!
Yes.
Oh my God, that's so gross. That is so gross. But I'm ready.
You want
I'm
to
ready. I'm getting over. I'm getting over.
I can't believe that I finally made it to the Harlem Globetrotters. I've been dreaming about this for years.
Bears, but individually they are
Tom, Ed,
Amy,
Kumi,
Ellie,